empty hearts and neon lights. They're playing with my mind. Gotta get out of here tonight. Oh, I wanna run off and fly. And I'll tell myself it's fine to be alone. Just to find somewhere that finally feels like home. Oh, oh, oh. I hate all this overthinking. Oh, 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 oh.
Take me to a world of silver, no more heartbreaks, tears. Sorry, I'm really late.
I had shit to do
that I didn't know I was supposed to do until like 10 minutes before we were supposed to start streaming. So that went well, you know? I'm always planned. I have everything under control. What do you mean? Hello. Also, warning again, I have my window open, so if you hear someone scream, it is the neighbors. No one else. No one's dying, okay? Good. I'm like a mixture of like, I'm extremely cold, but I'm also like dead warm. And I don't know how that works, but I am dying at this very moment. So I'm sitting here in like shorts, trying to, you know, cool down, but also with a blanket to try and heat up. You know? Don't know how that works, but it's whatever. Kind of hard to hear over the music. Is it better now? I never know. My mic kind of does whatever it wants. I also brought an ice cream with me. Can you hear it? I brought an ice cream. I was like, I shouldn't eat it because I should save it. But then I was like, but it's ice cream. You know? You know, I feel like that was that makes sense, right? Good argument. It's a fair argument. Oh, also, by the way, while I was gone this week, my glasses broke. Sorry, I'm not starting the game, but I want to talk. My glasses broke. I only have one pair, guys. So it was kind of stressful. So my mom brought like the nail glue. Nail glue is a really good glue for the people I don't know. Like that shit sticks. It's supposed to like keep those nails on you like it is your own. So my mom has fixed it now for the second time. Put just bunch of glue on it, because it's like it's broken on the sections where they fuse the glasses together, if that makes sense. Because like it has these like crevices that like obviously has been put with like really good glue, but I'm sure I've just had these glasses for so long that it's been worn out, so that it opened. And obviously we don't have that glue and we don't have all the tools to fix it. So it broke. Yeah, it opened up and one of the glasses fell out and I was like, fuck. Fuck. My eyesight is like really bad. Really, really bad. So the fact that I couldn't use my glasses there for a little bit was really stressful. Because you gotta like think about it. For the people that don't have glasses, they're like, okay, yeah, I get it, you're blind, but... You gotta think it from my perspective of like, I can't see without it, really. Like, I can barely see the shapes. You know, if it's close enough, I can see the shapes. But otherwise, I can't. So, like, do you understand how stressful that is to basically go around? Everything is blurry. Like, trying to figure that out. It's like some fucking horror game, isn't it? Trying to figure out what's going on around you. It's not pleasant. So I basically forced my mom to hurry and fix my glasses before she went to work, like some days ago when they broke. Because I was like, I'm not walking my dog blind. I'm not going out with a dog that is anxious enough as it is, and then adding more anxiousness because I can't see anything, and then a dog that's literally sick. Like I'm not doing that. No, I'm not doing that. She fixed them. They broke like 2 days ago and then she fixed them again. It's going great over here. Because of that, it took a bit to start stream because I had to clean my glasses, but obviously they're kind of broke, right? So I was like anxiously, like really, really gently holding them and trying to not press anywhere. It was just a stressful experience. I wanted to see the screen at least a little bit. It is a little bit blurry because it's obviously not properly cleaned, but it's good.
it's okay. It's okay enough where I can see what the fuck I'm doing, you know. Before, it felt like I'd been crying with how dirty they were. I honestly don't know how I managed to get them that dirty. I really don't. No idea how I do that. Because it's not like I'm a fucking toddler and pressing on my glasses all the time. And I didn't cry. So I have no clue. No idea how I keep doing it. But I'm surely I'm doing it, clearly. Because every time I wake up, they're dirty as hell. I don't know.
Just a dirty lot, I suppose. I do know that, like, at the on the, like, top of my glasses,
like, the corner where they go over my eyebrows, I always get sunscreen there. Because my, like, my eyebrows touch my glasses there. And obviously I put sunscreen on my face, right? So, there's always sunscreen on my glasses, that's for sure. I know how that works. I'm opening my ice cream now, by the way. But, otherwise, I have no idea how they keep being so dirty. I really want someone to explain it to me, because what the fuck? Sleep with glasses on? No, of course not. No. But like, when I wake up and like take my glasses in my hands and put them on, they're always dirty. I don't know what the hell. Someone's gotta be using them while I'm asleep.
That's the only logical explanation, you know? Like, how otherwise?
No idea. Okay, everybody. So today, we have literally nothing to do. It's a problem. The thing is, we have things to do, but nothing that you guys will care about. So I was stressing. I need to stop lying. Well, I'm not lying. I'm exaggerating. We do have stuff to do, but it's nothing fun for you to watch. So yesterday, I was thinking a lot. I wasn't stressing. I was thinking a lot about what I should do.
So that you guys won't yell at me.
And I came to two conclusions. One, you will yell at me no matter what. And two, the only thing we can do is Utopia. So that's what we're doing. That's the conclusions that I came up with. It was just, God. Maybe clean your room. Right, the air. The air is like getting to the glasses or something. It gotta be it. Well, that's what I came up with. I was just joking with my mom about how it's very often that, like, I play Sims and then someone comes and whines why I'm not playing Minecraft, and then I play Minecraft and then someone comes and whines why I'm not playing another game. It's a continuous struggle of just I'm not playing the right game every time. Every time I'm doing something wrong. I need to really fix your lava pool. I'll fix it later, dude. Man. Don't worry, I'm not actually upset. It was like a joke, right? I was laughing at it. It's really funny. I don't really take it too seriously because I'm just playing for fun. So like, you know, cry about it. Good choice to play Minecraft, right?
Well, I don't really have anything to do with Sims at the moment. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow or something, because it is a lot to just mine
like for like 3 hours. In like 2 days, you know, like 6 hours of just mining. It's not that fun. I don't mind it, but I know that it's not that fun.
I have enough brain cells to know it's not that fun. So we might just like do something, you know, since tomorrow or something, just to like break the cycle a little bit.
But that's fine. Hold on, we gotta remove some stuff from my inventory just to get some space. Also, before we continue, let's get some food.
Use moss.
Well, I don't want that though. I've done that before and it was just kind of annoying. And it's really expensive too with the bone meal and everything. It's just expensive. We can do a little bit of it because we did need a little more moss. But, like, still, I don't want to, like, use too much. Right. Excuse me? What the fuck? You have a problem or something? Do you want to fight? Let's fight!
Oh, loser.
I swear I have two llamas. No, wait. Camels. Where did the other one go?
Man, every time.
Oh wait, it's over there, isn't it? Wait.
Where did I put the fucking camel?
I keep losing my damn animals.
Oh, right, yeah, it is over there. Cool.
Okay, we're fine.
Jesus.
We really need to build a farmhouse. Where it... I keep losing my food. We really need to build a farmhouse. Because that means that we're gonna get rid of, like, most of the animals here. Just be rich, right? Oh, God. It that's exactly the same energy as, those people on internet that's like, why homeless? Just buy a home. It's the dumbest shit. Oh god. Have you guys seen those, like, you know, like, what, 20-year-olds, like, white guys that, you know, is giving, like, tips on how to become a millionaire? And they're like, invest. And you're sitting there and, like, I kind of see what they mean, but, like, what the fuck are they supposed to invest with? This, like, 19-year-old boy in McDonald's are gonna invest with what exactly? Because they're saying, basically, that they want you to, like, buy an apartment and then, like, invest in that. And then, like, you know, it becomes, like, expensive and then you sell it and all that. But, like, buy it with what? My soul? God.
Sometimes, man. Sometimes I don't get the internet.
At least we got a bunch of bone. Don't buy so much avocado toast, then you can buy a house. Exactly the energy. So weird. Oh, it's the same post from, like, all of these moms as well that keeps doing the, like, if you didn't buy the $5 Starbucks, I don't know how expensive Starbucks is, then you're gonna have, like, this much at the end of the year. And then there's always, always someone that reply to those posts and are like, okay, Karen, but I have depression, so Starbucks it is. And I respect that. I respect those feelings a lot. I validate them. Fair enough, you know? I think we should just normalize doing whatever you want with your own money. It's your money, do what you want, as long as you know nothing morally wrong, I suppose. I never tried Starbucks. I had a hot chocolate from Starbucks, and I had an allergic reaction, so that went well. I don't drink coffee, so I haven't had any Starbucks. Plus, it only recently became a thing in Sweden. It's not really, like, you know, when, like, having a Starbucks every morning became, like, a popular thing on the internet. That's when, like, Sweden started, like, getting Starbucks all around. Otherwise, it was just normal coffee shops. I was gonna do something. Right, moss. I need to eat my ice cream before it melts. Getting dark. Yeah. I'm numb. Gosh, I love the internet sometimes. Although, like I told you guys before, I was gone. Jesus, sorry. Last week, right? Like from Instagram, or like my friend group, more or less. I got ice cream on my nose. That was not the most cliche thing ever happening to me. I don't know what. I am literally a toddler. What the hell? Fuck you. Don't make fun of me. I can feel the judging. I did nothing wrong. I'm innocent. I'll cry. I'll simply cry. Are we 99 followers? Maybe that it is. Something like that. 98, yeah, exactly. Very close.
Yeah. I really, really want a job so I can give you guys all the games that I've been promising.
By the way, I know that like I haven't done the games that have been on like my followers' like goals. I am gonna do them, by the way. Like, I've written everything down. I just don't have the money to buy them right now. But I'm 100% gonna do all of them. So like, what is it now? It's...
Yeah, Minecraft Dungeons, yeah.
I don't have the money for it. I'm not gonna have the money for it when we hit it. But I'm gonna write it down on my list, and then we're gonna do it. I have a whole list, I promise. I haven't forgotten a single thing.
It's all there staring at me.
Waiting for me to do it. So don't worry about that. You're gonna get your games.
Use keys instead of buying directly from a store. A lot cheaper that way.
I'll look into it. Thank you.
Yeah. No, but I'm like stone broke. Like, do you want to see all the zeros?
Do you want it?
Like, it's bad. It's okay.
It also makes sense considering that I don't have a job, does it?
I'm writing down what you said. I have bad memory, so I need to write everything down you guys tell me to do. So I don't forget it. The memory is not my strong point, okay?
It's never been my strong point, don't judge me. Again, I will simply cry.
Does it do it with a stone? Oh, that's beautiful. How fun. Look how pretty it is.
It's so comfy. We should do that. Like, at the bottom? Wouldn't you think so? That would be the smartest way, wouldn't it? We'll do this at the bottom of the cave when we've mined all this out. We can just place this bunch of stone just at the top, like the bottom.
What games are you thinking of playing? Hold on. I'll bring up the notes. I gotta find them, though.
Okay.
Let's see. We have a bunch of stuff here. Right. I promised to get a multiplayer server with you guys so we could play on. Life is Strange 1, 2, and True Colors, Raft, Abzu, Stardew Valley, Gris. Everybody's Gone to the Rapture. That Disney game that I thought was cool. Obviously that Sampa thing, and there was one more. Terraria. That was one. I've been checking out that
a little extra hard these past, like, weeks. Like, batting a little of a stronger eye on Terraria.
So I'm eating my ice cream, I don't know what to tell you.
Wrong way. Because Terraria is, you know, like a longer game, so to say, you know? Survival, you know, Minecraft but pixel edition, you know?
So that's something that we could do to add a little bit more variety.
Because, like, sure, I can, like, play Life is Strange, but it's gonna end, and I'm not gonna be able to just replay it continuously, am I?
But that's something I can do with Terraria.
So that is like a good option to add more variety to the game. I told you guys about this like 1,000 times before, but I'm not going to play a horror game. So stop crying. Because it's just not gonna happen. I did once for Halloween just to be nice to you guys, but I'm not doing it again. Nope. You're going to have to cry about it. I don't remember who it is that constantly is asking me to play a horror game, but I'm not gonna do it, so, you know?
I really don't like horror games.
Oh, watching play horror games would be fun though. I really don't like it. I really don't. I know that some people like being scared. Well, okay. I like being scared. I just don't like it. I don't like the feeling of being scared. Same thing with roller coasters and stuff. I don't like that adrenaline thing. Don't like it. So I ain't gonna do it. Does anybody know if that's Disney game? It's like a long time game. Or if it's like a one type of thing. I think it's long, isn't it? Like it goes for a long time. I'm pretty sure it does. I'm unsure though. See, this just takes so long. Hold on, let me just save my diamonds before something happens to them. There you go. Yeah. But we got a bunch of games we could do. I think would be really cool. Terraria is definitely one that I'm interested in. Stardew Valley looks kind of cozy and nice. Or it's Combi Moss, I think. I'm not taking any chances. Not that I'm particularly broke, but, you know. I want the diamonds anyways. You know, it's one of those, old player kind of things, where, when you see diamonds, you act like it's the rarest thing on earth. I do the same thing with horses. And it's ridiculous, because it's been ages since we got horses. And I still look at them like, a horse! Like, yeah, Sapiba, it's a fucking horse. You've seen them continuously for years. What do you mean? Like, they're not rare anymore. God, it's like a broken player thing. Like, I just recently, in the past, few years, got used to the fact that, irons are not rare. Because I used to play on my phone, right? I used to play Minecraft on my phone. And there, iron is as rare as diamond. So, you know, for a long time, I was like, whoa, iron. That was, the greatest thing, playing on the computer. Was being able to actually get iron stuff, because I remember I had to choose what was it between a pickaxe and a bucket. I chose the bucket because I wanted to make a cake. God, I am great. My childhood self is the greatest thing on earth. I chose the fucking bucket because I wanted a cake. And do you know what was worse? I don't know if this existed on the computer as well, but on the phone, they would it would take the iron, you know, in Minecraft now when you make a cake, it emptied the buckets and take the milk, right? In the game before, in the phone, it would take the iron as well. So you just lose an entire bucket for making a fucking cake. Actually ridiculous.
Terraria would probably be more interesting to watch than Stardew Valley.
Yeah, it's more into what I'm doing, isn't it? But I do want to do Stardew Valley as well. Just more long games, I guess. I don't know what to call it, but long lasting. Maybe we could call it long-lasting games. I think we got enough moss now. It looks like fucking explosion, bro. Iron farms, let me introduce myself. Yeah. It wasn't that easy on the phone. Easier said than done. I don't even know if villagers really was a thing back then. Can't remember. You're sure as hell was an experience. God, I remember. I remember my little Minecraft world. I wonder if I could ever possibly get that back. I doubt it. It gotta be gone now. Gotta be gone for now.
I remember, I built a big chair. One more. I made these like weird tunnels.
I can't remember what they were for. I had a sheep farm as well, where I had put a pink sheep, and the pink sheep died. It was a naturally spawned pink sheep, by the way. I tried to play Terraria on my phone a while ago, but couldn't use the controls. Yeah.
No, like, once you have it on computer, you can't really get used to it on phone.
But, like, I started with Minecraft on my phone, right? And I would play with my friends in school. And then I got it on the computer. That gotta be, like, the best investment my mom has ever done for me. Because, like, I still play Minecraft, right? Sorry.
Like, that gotta be the best, like, money investment she's ever done to me.
That and, like, summer camp. Because sometimes you buy kids
stuff and, like, they don't, like, ever really use it
after a while.
Or, like, they just grow out of it.
I'm still here, like, talking about friends I made from summer camp and, like, playing Minecraft in front of you guys. You have to have been, like, the best investment she's ever done. Respectable.
What the fuck do I do about this big ass hole?
I don't know. Gotta work on that one. Okay, what do we mine? Maybe we should mine here. But yeah. Fill it? Oh, we're not doing that. The fuck? Don't give me trauma. Goodness. I have enough with placing things, okay? Enough. I have like PTSD from placing the snow on Stone Edge. God, I'm never doing that again. No, I'm not. Fuck no. God, trauma. I just keep thinking about it and just know. Because like it always took 1 hour and then I was always really tired. And like you guys don't understand because like I did it off stream as well. And you can go back in my VODs and see how many VODs it was just me placing snow. So many. And like sometimes like you won't even see it from the title because I will like, you know, I will do something else during the stream and then I will like finish the stream with placing some snow. And then, like, I would do it off stream, right? Placing snow for, like, a really long time. God, it was just endless. Endless. I think it made it harder because of, like, the fact that it was kind of a mountain-ish area. So, like, it was harder to place it correctly and everything. Because you had like these little like caves that you had to like go around and make it look normal. And obviously we had a few like mountain parts and it went very like up and down. If it would have been just pretty flat, then it would have been a lot easier. You know, a lot and like flab with like barely any like trees. So much easier. But no, of course not. Instead, it was just a bunch of woods and just up down, around, around. God. Well, that was an experience. Never want to do that again. Yeah, be cool. The force didn't make it easier. Yeah, exactly. It really didn't. God. Maybe it's fun and it was okay because look what we got at the end. A really, really nice place. I'm gonna add some more animals and stuff into it at some point. More villagers are gonna live there. It's gonna be great. If I do that kind of brain stuff, I usually do something else at the same time, like listening to audiobooks or watching YouTube. Yeah, exactly. That's what I did off stream. But because of that, when I was streaming doing it, I got tired within an hour. Because obviously, I have to like keep talking. But like, there's nothing... I have nothing to say, right? Like, I can't, like... How am I supposed to do commentary on placing snow? I just kept complaining about how tired I was and trying to like remember something that I wanted to share with you guys. It's just, it's really difficult. Even like with mining now, it's still like, what I'm saying is like very limited. I don't have much to say, which is why it's really difficult if people don't chat during streams that are chill, because it's just, my mind is empty. I really don't got anything to add. Today I had like a little, some few things to share that happened during the week. Which again, is also why I don't think that I'm gonna be able to ever like stream like 3 hours every day or something like that. Cause like, I won't have anything to say. Cause like, after a week of being gone, I have like stuff to share with you guys, right? Like, tell you guys interesting stuff. But like, if I were to do it every day, I would just, nothing would happen. Nothing fun would happen. The struggles of streaming. Having nothing to say. Also, do you have music on? You do have music on, okay. Tell me if the music is off, because I'm not using my headset today. I'm not listening to any music. So I can't hear shit. Start counting to 1 million in case of silence. Honestly.
But yeah, what even happened this week? Like, rarely anything ever happens in my life. It's pretty chill. What happened?
Riot? I think it's a series. I'm still confused if it's a series or a movie, but Enigma, I think it's called. Just got like announced today that it's gonna come out the 15th July, so that's fun. My friend screamed a lot once I told her. she had been waiting for that.
The company called GMTV announced
that, like, again, series or movie. Don't know. But
basically, they announce like a few stuff. Some stuff is like a surprise,
but you know, that's like one or two things as a surprise. The rest is like, you know, you get to know before. And they do these like year end live streams where they announce like they show the trailer and everything's like wah, and then the actors, like the main cast, comes out on stage and talk like a little bit about it, together with like the director.
And yeah, they come out and talk a little bit about it, and then the next trailer gets shown, and then those main cast come out and talk.
You do get it?
That's what they do at like the end of the year, every year, to like announce the next year's stuff that's gonna come. And this Enigma series / movie got announced at the end of 2022 that it was gonna come out this year. And my friend was really excited about it. And today, the official trailer dropped. They basically give you like a, I don't know what it's called. It's like an alpha trailer or something. Basically like a basic trailer that gets the point across. Like they film that first, and then later, like months later, they start actually filming the show, and then they make the trailer, and then they drop that. Right? So they made like this whole trailer for like that live stream in 2022. And then now, today, they drop the like official real trailer. And when they do that, it means that it gets announced. Like it gets a date.
The trailer drops, the poster drops, and it drops on like all of their platforms, like all of their social media. And then you get a date. You know, it says like 15 July on the poster, for example. It's what they do. It's I've learned their schedule, how they do things. Because I like a lot of their stuff, so I keep up with them.
And that's what happened today. And I'm excited, because it looks really interesting. I don't really know what the hell is going on. It's very mysterious. But it looks cool. It's like some demonic school energy. It's really cool.
It's really cool.
In the trailer, the first trailer that we got, she opened the door.
Like, from it being like a really nice school,
she opened the door, and then it was like trashed and demonic, and I...
Yeah. It was cool, though.
So I'm interested to see that. I also need, like, shows to watch. I can't find anything interesting. I keep looking at it, and I'm just like, no.
Like, what was it? Like, some days ago, I was like, maybe I should give, like, The Walking Dead a try. Like, I've always liked the whole, like, zombie thingy. I think it's really cool.
So I was like, yeah. And then I was like, no, never mind.
Because I remembered how it ended up, and it's kind of trash. It starts out really good, and then they kind of fuck the whole show over. So that sucks.
So I guess I'm not watching The Walking Dead now.
So I have no idea what to watch. So I'm just like in a desperate mode of like all the series and the movies that I know is supposed to come out to just come out already. Please. Please. Like, I'm even waiting for shows that I didn't even care about when they got announced, just because I'm that desperate to just watch something.
I just need something to keep me company.
Walking Dead is a drama series disguised as action.
The thing is, like, it's good. Like, I like the whole, like, idea of it, but they fuck it up.
Like, what was it, like, after, like, at the start of, like, fifth or sixth season, it's just fucked up. And then it kind of tries to save itself at the like very end, like the last season. It's just no. And then I remember I've watched a like whole like go through of the entire show, because I didn't want to watch it right once I remember how it ended up.
So I've watched a guy like talking about the entire thing, and yeah, it's bad. It's really bad.
The theme song is fine, though. True.
I wish I could just, like, watch the beginning seasons and just be satisfied with that.
What if I can, like, manipulate myself, like, gaslight myself into, like, thinking that, like, oh, it's over now after, like, season four? I think I can do that. Just gaslight myself into thinking that it's, like, ended. Because, like, up until that point, it's good. But then after that, it's kind of fucked up. Really sets the theme well for the series. Yeah, I remember watching the pilot when it aired. I got traumatized. For years, no joke. An 11-year-old should not watch that. I don't even remember if I was 11, but I was really young. Yeah, it was not a good idea. No. Because the episode one is also the scariest. So that was just dumb. Right? Like, your child should not watch that. That's just dumb choice. But of course, me as a child did not get that. You know? So I got a nightmare that was stuck with me for years. Like, years. Like, so long. 15 years ago now? I don't fucking know. I can't remember. But I was really young. I remember seeing the pilot. Airing.
What was my mom doing? She was doing the laundry. I asked her if I could watch. And I had to, like... I had to convince her to let me watch.
I did. And I shouldn't have convinced her. Really shouldn't have. It's a long-running series. Yeah, it really is. But I remember watching that. That's why I'm like, I'm pretty aware of the show as well. Because of that. I remember it so well. It really, like, put a memory into my soul. So that's why I was like, oh, I can watch that. And again, I remember that it ended up pretty bad. So, oh, sucks.
And, like, I've already rewatched Teen Wolf, so I don't want to watch that. It's come to a point where, like, you have to just rewatch the good shows because I can't find anything good
that's new.
I did watch Queen Charlotte. That was good. But it was also pretty, like, stretched out. It's not my usual taste, but it wasn't bad. But it's not something that, like, I'm gonna, like, become a fan over, if that makes sense.
You know, a lot happened in those years. They moved camp a few times in the story. Kind of. Like, I don't necessarily mind the whole, like, not a lot of things happened, but they definitely, I think, ruined everything with the choices they made. Spoiler alert, everybody that's watching right now, because I'm about to tell shit that definitely is spoilers. For example, like, killing off a lot of characters that should not have died. And also the ending is literally just an ad for other series, which is actually ridiculous. Like, it's so stupid.
When this person that did the whole, like, recap of everything and talked about it and why it was this and this and this,
they did a whole analysis and I was listening to it. When they told me about the ending, because obviously I haven't seen the ending, my mouth fell open in shock. I was like, what?
Seriously?
It was just a big ad for, like, a bunch of other shows. That's ridiculous. Can't believe they had the guts to do that. That's so wild. The Asian guy Glenn, I think, was his name. If I'm really knowing, they killed him. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Glenn was his name.
I think that it would have worked if Nick, the main character, died. But... And I think even, like, Glenn would have made sense. But I feel like they should have kept the damn son.
Okay?
He should have been alive. And it's the worst writing decisions they have ever made is kill him off.
Because when you watch, like, as someone that is a really big fan of, like, just movie, like, zombie movies and series like that, I'm such a huge fan of that, like, entire, like, concept.
You want to follow someone's success, and it doesn't mean that they even have to end up surviving at the end, but then it means that they have to die, and that is the end.
If there's multiple main characters, then you can kill other main characters, but someone has to be kept until the end. And they killed off everybody from the beginning, which makes it so that, like, when you watch the beginning, you don't really want to watch until the end. Because why are you supposed to follow all of these people if they're even going to die? Anyways. Like, it's just... It loses the whole concept. You want to see them survive and struggle through. And you want that realness of death. Which is why, like, I don't like the whole, like,
bringing people back to life kind of thing.
Because that makes the entire zombie concept just not scary anymore.
You need it to be terrifying.
That's how, like, you're kept on edge, because it's fucking scary. That's why season one is, like, it works. Because they're genuinely terrified of them. And it also has to do with the fact that, like, it just happened, right? So, like, it's new and they have no idea what the fuck is happening, right? But, like, you need that fear. That is what makes it scary. Is the whole, like... Wait, can I jump down there? Yeah, I can. Can I? I'll survive. But, like, that's what makes it good. Is that fear factor. But, like, when they kill off Glenn and then he comes back and then he dies... It's just dumb. It's just absolutely dumb. It loses the whole, like, trust thing of, like, when they're dead, they're dead. Because that puts, like, a real, like... Real...
I don't know what to say, how to explain it, but, like, it puts a real feeling.
Kind of like a realness check. That, like, they can all die. I said the same thing about Stranger Things when Max... damn near died. They're like not the like when she's in a hospital, but like when she almost gets taken by the like graveyard thing.
But like I think that was a great choice to add that, because during the entire show everybody's been okay,
right? But like they're fighting demons. Logically someone would have died by now. And if they don't want to kill them, I like that they added the fact that like someone got seriously hurt towards the end of the show. Cause that puts the viewers in a more real situation of like they can just die. Like it's real. Okay, I won't talk more about Stranger Things then. Sorry.
But yeah, just, I like that.
The, like, the when you put it like that. And that is what carries, like, the zombie concept of, like, anybody could die. And I think it's fine with, like, making a lot of people die in, like, The Walking Dead. But, like, you have to keep someone. Towards the end, and I don't remember the son's name, but he was the perfect choice for that. And I like the whole, like, you know, he lost his eye thing, or like maybe it could have broken something else. I like that he got hurt, but he didn't die. Right? Have you seen The Last of Us TV series?
Yes, I have. I absolutely have.
I really like the game. I haven't seen all of the game, so don't spoil the damn game, okay? I haven't seen all of the game yet.
But I really, really like just the whole story.
But I've seen the entire, like, series. Season one, obviously.
Just, you know. I think just The Walking Dead really, really fucked it up. It made... It screwed over the entire concept. It really did.
Because I do like what they play around with. And like the whole like... I know the surviving part. The finding shelter part. The this and this and that. Blah 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 blah.
I like that. That's fine. But it's very like... Yeah, I think they really screwed it up towards, like, the middle there.
After, like, season 5, they screwed up. And it became this very, like, unrealistic thing.
Which, to me, what's scary about the zombie concept is when you add the realistic touch to it.
And it's scary then. How, like, they walk into the woods and, like, it's too quiet. You know, those kind of, like, the uneasiness is what's good with, like, the zombie concept. Like, they walk into the woods and it's just quiet. Or, like, they walk into the trails and then just out of nowhere, like, just a
bunch of zombies come out of the woods.
Now that's good shit.
Like, that uneasiness of, like, you do not know, like, if you just run into, like, a fucking horde of them.
You know?
That's just top tier shit.
But yeah, like I said, The Walking Dead really screwed over that concept. They had it perfectly in the beginning, but then it just kind of got ruined.
I didn't like the TV series in general. I dropped a few episodes in, but the first episode was really good with the action and zombies. But don't worry, I haven't played the game, so can't spoil anything about that.
But I really like it.
I think it's really good. It did really well with that as well. They definitely hit the hole with the, like, the scariness of it. Especially when they did the scene with the clicker. That was really good.
I like the uneasiness with, you know, something going slow,
if that makes sense.
I like the whole, like, fast action too. I think that works, like, most of the time, but I like when they're supposed to, like, show something being terrifying, how, you know, they slow everything down. It becomes, like, quiet. Right, like, really calm and quiet.
And then, like, with the clicker, right, it does the clicking sound. And that's, like, the only thing you can really hear. You can even hear the, like, click, the click sound echoing.
Like, it's really, they did it well.
Until I put in the fear factor of it. Absolutely. And obviously, they are, like, just... Those zombie thingies are obviously, like, objectively, like, more scarier. Because they're not these slow, like, terrifying things, like, in The Walking Dead.
You know, like, these fucking things have, like, exploding shit on them. Like, that's scary.
You know, it kind of, like, carries itself, because the zombies are more, like, I don't know, demon-like, I guess. Supernatural-like. But, yeah. God. I really wish that I could find, like, another
zombie-like show, because I really love the zombie concept.
I wish someone could have done it again. Maybe the Last of Us will bring it back.
I'd love that.
And someone could make another and not fuck it up. You know? It would have been great. Oh my god, I'm blind again.
A window is behind me, so I can't see shit.
Bam, bam, bam. Yeah, I'm just waiting for my shows, not gonna lie. I think that I'm waiting for one specific show the most, which is Only Friends. And that's supposed to be aired at, like, the end of August, start of September.
We don't have a date yet. They're still filming.
But they could definitely finish that in a month, of course. So.
We'll see when that happens. And when that happens,
I'm going to just die. Metaphorically. Twitch, metaphorically. I'm not actually going to get harmed. But it's definitely going to be an experience. I can't wait. I'm really just a big fan of, like, cinema in general.
And just stories in general.
Not that I read many books, but, like, I still think the books are, like, awesome and cool, and I love it. So, like, you know, books, tales, stories, series, movies, shows, you know,
all of that.
I like myself a good story. So, that's why you probably hear me talk about, like, series and movies a lot. Because I just really love it.
Have you seen the film Train to Busan? Of course I have.
It's the greatest thing ever. That is... Wow. Wow. That is probably the greatest thing I've ever seen. That was... Wow. Yeah. That was good. Talk about emotions.
I was a fucking wreck at that end.
Jesus Christ. They really know how to just kill you emotionally. God.
That's what I'm talking about, what I'm saying, like. You gotta keep the main cast until the end.
That's what I mean.
Also, warning, by the way, any shows that we're gonna bring up now is going to be spoilers. So, you know, just telling, because I'm going to say spoiler things.
Have you seen the series All of Us Are Dead?
Yep.
Seen that too. Also really good. Love that. I remember laughing so much how this dude kept being like yeeted off the building and still manages to keep climbing up the building.
It made me laugh so hard. Not in a like obnoxious like they're so stupid kind of way. Just in like this dude just really, really ain't gonna die. Like he just keeps going. No one's stopping him. It was really funny. But I really did like the more realistic thing. Also, they made me cry like every episode. All of Us Are Dead made me literally cry like every episode. Like, what the fuck? God. It was really good.
Oh, the construction site, right?
But, like, not just that, but, like, the school rooftop as well. They keep throwing this dude off of, like, windows, you know, the roof, and he keeps just climbing up like a fucking spider. Like, bro. Bro. Seriously? Just no one's stopping him. If he wants to climb, he's gonna climb. Clearly.
I should watch some shows today.
It makes me, like, in a show-watching mood.
Like I said before, I divide, like, a lot of, shows into, like, smaller,
like, sections. So I have West
shows, and then I have K-dramas into one, and, like, LGBTQ shows into one.
So I have LGBTQ shows, K-dramas, animes, and Western stuff, and then the Western stuff is divided into series and movies.
And I find nothing interesting from the West.
I can't find any K-dramas that I like, because all of them have one of the three concepts that I hate, which is one of the main characters dying, two, an interesting plot, and three, not a love triangle. They don't have any of these. Like, it's always one that they gotta have, and I hate it so much. Fucking hell.
So,
I'm just crying in frustration every time I'm watching, trying to find a K-drama. I really want to watch them. I swear to God. I'm really trying, but I can't find anything.
It's like the LGBTQ shows are, like,
carrying for me right now. Because that's the thing that, like, I can actually find. That, like, find anything remotely interesting.
I made this whole, like, list where I rank all of them.
I like organization. I don't know what to tell you. I think it's fun.
I think the whole, like, you know, like, ranking them and, like, making this, like, fun, like, system. I thought that was really fun. So now I've just kept to it. There's a bunch of them that are, like, pretty meh and lame, but those are usually, like, the ones made in Korea, and that's not because the Korean ones are bad, no.
That's because the Korean ones are 15 minutes episodes long, and there are 8 episodes, and there's not really any good cinematography you can put into that. It's very much like a school project. Not in terms of quality, but in terms of, like, how much you can put into something. Like, you can't have this, like, really amazing, incredible thing when it's so short.
So that's, like, the lame stuff you can get when it comes to queer shows, but otherwise,
There's a bunch of great ones. I've watched, what is it? I'm rewatching the clips right now. It's the 8th time I watched it now.
I really like it. I really like it.
Yeah. I'm stuck with it. I don't know what to tell you. Well, K-dramas have this thing I don't like particularly called drama.
Yeah, I don't mind it. I really, really hate the love triangle, and I hate it always because they're also choosing the wrong person every time. It pisses me off so much. What is it? I haven't seen this one, but what the hell is that one called? It's really popular. I don't remember,
but it's one that's like a little bit more like low-key emo guy, you know, that's like sarcastic, funny, and then the other one is, you know, pretty and cute and handsome. And this girl that apparently is like, you know, big and like glasses and all of that, and she gets like a makeover. She's so pretty. And then like they have like this love triangle complication thing with like these two guys, and she chooses
the basic bitch.
I'm sorry, but he's such a basic person.
Then like I really like when I heard that she shows him, I was like,
I didn't even watch it and I was disappointed. Like, I didn't even watch the show and I was like, is she serious with me right now?
God, I hate it so much. I don't know like why Korea has such a problem with like
making stuff like that good.
But like they always choose the wrong person and they always kind of act like idiots.
And not in a like, haha, they're an idiot, in a like, what the hell are you doing kind of way. You know?
Korea and their love triangles, I hate them so much. They need to stop making them. Because it just frustrates me to the end
of time. Can't handle it. I really can't.
God.
I don't remember which, what the hell the name was called. It's a really, really popular one.
But God.
No, when I heard that, like, she so shows the, like, obvious, you know, like the, oh, he's so kind, he's smart, he's handsome, instead of like the sarcastic funny guy that like is a little bit like low-key fruity, you know, she chooses the wrong person. Something.
He keeps choosing the wrong people. What was the other one that I watched?
I watched Love Alarm. That was good until I heard that she's choosing the main guy in season 2, and that was just, again, what the fuck? What the hell? So, you know, that's great. They have this thing of, like, keep ruining their own shows. Why does that keep happening? Can they stop? Please? I beg you? I remember when I was watching Love Alarm, I really respected how she shows who to love. Like, she decided that, like, she was not going to be with this dude and gave it a try with someone else and learn to love this dude. And now they're gonna just fuck that entire concept over. Because what? She really loves him. Why? Because he has big eyes?
Oh, God.
No, the entire love triangle concept, I hate it so much. Hate it. Despise it.
You.
Nope. I can't do it.
I think it's more obnoxious than K-dramas, and I don't know why.
But it is more obnoxious than K-dramas. It definitely is. They're just good at being bad at it, I guess.
Do you like intentionally bad films like Sharknado?
I haven't seen that. But, not really.
Not really. I know, it really depends on the genre of anything. I never really know what to say, like, when people ask, like, what do you like to watch?
And, like, then to, like, give details about it. Because I find it really difficult. Because my likes are very, like, broad.
Because, you know, like, I really like Train to Busan, for example, and all of those. I really do love the, like, zombie concepts. But then, like, with The Walking Dead, they fucked that one over. So I don't like that.
I do love the rom-coms. But, like, not all of them. Some of them are, like, really bad. I don't know, it's just, I'm confused.
I wouldn't say that I like, intentionally bad stuff. But I do like when they write stuff and it's not supposed to be good in a sense of, like,
you know, maybe they write, like, two characters that are just, like, completely fucked up for each other. Like, they're unhealthy. Right? And that's the intention. I kind of like those. I think those are interesting. And a lot of kids seem to not be able to tell two things apart from that. I've noticed. I've seen a lot of hate of a few shows. Can't remember their names. Memory loss, you know? But basically, they're like, intentionally, like, making these, like, two characters, like, fucked up. Because they have, like, a fucked up story, right? So, like, their love is, like, kind of toxic, right? And I've seen a lot of people on the internet be, like, really trashing them. Like the intention wasn't that they're unhealthy. That was, like, the intention from the beginning. You know what I mean? Like, it was never meant to be a healthy relationship. That was the point. It is a bad relationship. You know? That's the whole story. I do think those are kind of cool. Because it kind of plays with your morals a little bit. Really does. I don't know. That's such a, like, wide variety of, like, stuff that I find interesting or, like to watch. I don't know. Oh my god, my legs are dying. Oh, ow. Hold on.
I don't have anything. I'm pulling up my nose. It's nothing interesting.
Ugh. Struggles.
I want to watch something fun. There's nothing. Nothing. I'll just be in forever pain, I suppose. Struggle will never end.
Ugh, I'm just gonna have to be in pain until something interesting comes out. That's simply what's gonna have to happen. I can't see anything. For the people that don't know, I have a window behind me, that's why I can't see anything. So, like, the light from outside is a little too bright for me to see what the hell I'm looking at. We don't have a lot to do in Minecraft at the moment.
Because I still gotta plant Copperdale and I don't know what the fuck to do with that.
I'm still in a struggle with that one.
So, like,
what do I do about today? Do we just keep the stream short? Is that okay?
I don't have anything else to do.
It's not gonna be fun to mine for, like, 3 hours. I'm gonna finish this section, but then, like, how do we want it? I don't know. Oh, also, I told you guys that I write stories, right? I finished one of them. This is actually great. And my friend really liked it. It's just also success. You know, win-win.
Hey.
Ah!
Wait a minute, you meant all this without a beacon?
Yeah. All by hand.
Wanna share it? Oh, absolutely not.
It's my little secret.
Okay, I'm fine.
I never trust myself. Because, like, I'm so used to, like, almost dying from everything. I'm still not used to feather falling.
Gosh.
I remember that I made an account on AO3. Like a public account. I don't remember what I called it.
Probably something very boring.
Probably. Maybe I could post something there.
Could I?
If I ever make a more fancy story, then I'll share it with you guys. Because the ones I'm making aren't like that long, you know? It's kind of like, you know, it could be in a fucking newspaper. You know what I mean? Like, it's short. If I make something proper and, like, you know, like, this is something I would flex to my, like, my relatives, then I'll post it. And then I'll share you the link. Okay? We can make that deal. If there's something that, like, if I share with my relatives, then I share with you guys. Usually I share more things with you guys, though, than I do, like, with my family. Which is kind of worrying. But I guess that also makes sense, because, like, the whole concept is about me talking. Right? It's the concept about me talking for hours. It makes sense. I don't just sit and talk with, like, one of my cousins for 3 hours. It doesn't really happen. Right? Makes sense. But when it comes to my writing, I keep it very much to, like, myself and, like, my friends. So, like, if I share it with them, then I'll share with you guys. Otherwise, you basically get the friend treatment, too. I talk to you guys like I know you. You know, like, for all I care, you guys are my besties. You know, like, literally. I think I even called you guys besties, like, last week. I didn't know what to call you, and I felt like I've been using guys for too much. So I called you besties. You know? I never, like, I always do that. Like, I treat strangers like they're my friends. Not in a, like, best friend, like, you know, like, into their space kind of way, but, like, in a general friend kind of way. I do that all the time. That's why I was struggling in school with writing formal, because I'm just not a formal person. Ever. I'm always just really casual and friendly. Like, the only time I'm not casual or friendly is when I have anxiety or I'm shy. But even then, I'm not mean. I'm just quiet then. You know? It's just... I remember I was struggling so hard to write informal. It's the most horrible thing. And you know what the best thing is when you can write freely and just do whatever you want? Is that when my fucking automatic, you know, like, correction comes up and it's like, you should put a comma. I'm like, you know what? Fuck you. I'm not gonna do that. I'm, like, protesting, because I use Grammarly to assist me sometimes, just to, like, go through with it, to make sure that, you know, it makes kind of sense. I do it by myself. I'm not really listening to that thing, but it's mostly to point out the obvious mistakes, because my computer is in Swedish, and I read in English, so, like, you know, it can't correct my English, you know?
And every time it says something, that's like, you should do this, you do that. I'm like, you know what?
No. I feel like I'm just a rebellious teen or something against Grammarly. I'm like, no. I can do what I want. And that's literally what I'm gonna do. Like, if I ever end up making, like, a book or something, I swear to God, I'm not gonna listen to any rules. There are gonna be so many people that are gonna be upset that I'm, like, not using enough, like, dots or something. And I'm gonna be like, you know what? Screw you. My book, my rules. Oh, I hated that about school. I get it. But I hated how it was so, like, if you put too much, like, of, like, really or something, they would be like, it's too much. Like, what if I wanted it to be that much, though? Like, it was so, like, individual creativity is so limited in school. Because obviously they have to, like, rate it, I guess, you know, give it a grade. But it's so, like, it kind of ruins the whole creativity process of, like, you getting a grade on your creativity. Like, not everything is subjective, you know? I always found that a bit odd. Like, when you were writing something, I'm like, that's not this, so this is not that, that's not a good ending. I'm like, this is my story, though. What if I really liked the ending? I remember writing something in school once, and I really liked the ending. And she was like, that's not an ending. I was like, well, it stops. It's obviously an ending. I was like, huh? No, just, I really dislike school when it comes to that. Especially writing, because it's all about grammar and all of that, right? When it's about, like, writing stories, hated that. Hated it. So now that I'm writing my own shit, I'm having a blast. Because I can, like, protest. It's saying that, like, I'm using too much of, like, really?
What is it I always say? I always use one word a lot.
Literally. That's what I use a lot. And it always tells me that, like, you don't have to use that. And I'm like, yes, I do, actually. Screw you. Nah, I mean, I'm like, if I ever make a book, I'm gonna just do it to protest. Against just all grammar. How about, like, I just make a book where I don't use any dots? Have fun reading that. Just, like, something so, like, dumb. But, like, it puts the point across, you know? I was just, like, me sitting here at home, you know, writing my little story and just seeing how, like, autocorrect wants me to, like, remove a word. And I'm like, no. I'll do what I want. It's my story. It really feels like some fucking teenage, like, protest. It's so much nicer, though. Like, it's really fun to actually read, like, read and write something that's just people made for fun. I think that's why I like to, like, read a bunch of, like, just stories that people have made. I know people post a bunch of stuff on, like, Twitter, in, like, threads. And, like, obviously AO3. I stay away from Wattpad, that's a scary place. But AO3 has good stuff. AO3 is nice. Because there you can filter. So, like, if you don't want to write fucked up shit, you can, like, filter that out and you'll be fine. You can actually get the good stuff there, too. So, like, I like reading it. Because it gets noticed, right? When someone is writing something for just pure fun. Or if they're writing it because, like, they have to. Right? It's so easily noticeable. Because, like, when they're writing it forced, it's empty. It's so empty. But, like, I really adore the whole concept of AO3 where, like, someone can be, like, posting, like, a literally, like, 62 chapters long work of, like, completely original story, completely on their own, like, nothing, like, all of this is from their own head. And then we have, like, some random person in, like, I don't know, South Asia that wrote, like, a 200 word little, like, poem about a character from a show. Like, it's so so unique from one another, and I love it because everybody's just writing whatever they want, and I respect it so much. I love it. I love to read it when people are just reading what comes up in their mind. It's great. Claps to Creative freedom, everybody. Woohoo! It's great. Oh my god. I really wish that I could write a book. I don't think I have enough, like, mental space to be able to create such a big thing in my own head. I can write, like, small little scenes or something, or, like, general concepts, but, like, building an entire world from the beginning and, like, having all of these, like, down to, like, background characters, like, be, like, hitting. I don't think I'd be able to do it. It's the same thing, but, like, then I should, like, oh, you could study to learn how to do it. Well, if I study it, then we're gonna be in the problem of I'm not gonna have creative freedom anymore. Right? Then we're in the problem of I'm stuck in, like, my creative freedom is gonna be taken away. So what do I do then? Right? Shit. God damn it. I don't know. I don't know how I'm supposed to do it. I'm just gonna have to fake until I make it, I guess. I suppose that's gonna have to be what it is, isn't it? It isn't easy, it takes a long time to come up with. Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, it takes a lot. Like, it's a lot of things that goes into it.
You know, down to, like, every place that they're in, their entire families. I have a kind of characters and story in mind, in my head, at the moment. I've written down a bunch of stuff about it. I don't know if I'll ever do something about it. Ever. But, I mean, it would be cool if I could. But it's the same thing with, like, I'm probably gonna have to study that to be able to write a book. But if I study, then I'm gonna lose my creative freedom, and I don't want that. I really do not want that. So, guess we're gonna have to struggle. It's like, how do you even start a damn book? I feel like I'm gonna have to just plan for years and then try and figure out how to, like, write it. Because I'm gonna have to, like, plan, like, all of the characters beforehand. My biggest, like, pet peeve is when something is extremely messy. You know? Like, when something just gets thrown in the middle and, like, we're gonna have to pretend like it was already there in the beginning. Kind of thing. So I'm gonna have to, like, I don't know. I'm gonna have to plan everything. Down to, like, the places they go, the general personality of them, pronouns, and such, etc., etc. Right now, I don't have anything, really. I have the general setting, but I haven't really decided on that. That's just, like, a idea. It's not a decision. I have the general setting. They're in university. That's the, like, general setting, right? If you drag everything over a line, then university. That kind of sets, like, where we are in life as well, right? And then I have the two main characters' names decided. I'm not gonna share those with you. But I have the two main characters' names decided, and one of the main characters' little sister decided. That I do. But, like, that's about it. And I wanted to make their characters to be in the same friend group. That is also decided. But I need to write the friend group. And the family. And teachers. And all the other places they're gonna be at. Like, people's homes. And others just, like, one-time places. And, like, what's gonna happen, right? Because you have a general main storyline, which, like, if it's, like, a love story, then it's obviously, like, for two people to get together, right? That's the end. Like, that's a big storyline. But you need small plots in between the stories to keep it interesting. That's, like, take, like, any Netflix show and you'll get what I mean. Like, you need small little stories along the way to, like, keep it interesting and fun. Which is not, like, a to say that, like, if you don't do that, then it's boring. Well, it kind of is. But but it's just, like, that's how you keep an interest. And that's just, like, for you as well. It wouldn't be fun to write, like, them just, like, going to eat or something. You know? It just wouldn't.
So, it's a lot.
But I would love to write a book one day. That would be freaking cool as hell. I would love that. I would want to make a slow burn just to, like, hurt everybody. That would be fun. Imagine me make a slow burn. In, like, the third book, they hold hands.
Totally would do that.
Oh, that would be really fun. My favorite series that they came up with. That they threw playing D&D, like, a game for years. And at some point, they were like, what if we turn this into an actual series for others to read? And I think they spent like 10 years plus world building. Yeah, exactly. It's just a lot. And I feel like that's just what you're going to have to do. Is just get like a document or notes or a fucking book. And just like start writing down everything. And then start making like decisions on like, this is how it's supposed to be. Okay, that's done. And just like, you need sections, right? You need to plan like where it's supposed to start. Look at me while I'm talking. You need to plan like where it's supposed to start and where it's supposed to generally end. It's obviously going to be a little bit different because, you know, it changes while you're writing, but you need like a general like here to there, and you need to then build of like what is going to happen in between. And that's when you need to decide like where it's going to take place, because if you're like in high school, then a lot of it is going to be high school. Right? Through that time. If it's like university, a lot of it's going to be university, right? You need to decide on it. And then you need to decide on like what they're studying. Because that's going to be like a big thing, right? And then you need to decide like, how are they friends? Are they friends through school? Because if they're friends through school, then a lot of the settings where like they interact is going to be in the school. Are they like in a club outside of school? Then that's where a lot of the setting is going to be. Like, stuff like that. You need to decide on like every single thing, and then down to like everybody's families, and not just like the main cast. No, like I'm talking about this fucking dude that like just joined the friend group. You need to decide on like what his big sister that's like in freaking Chile right now what she's studying, because he's gonna mention that once, you know, like there's so many details that you need to have. And then down to like every character, all of their names, all of their pronouns, sexuality, general personality that they have, and like stuff that they care about. I don't have a big problem all of the time with like making characters be just like this person's friend, but I really, 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 really appreciate screenwriters when they make every character be individuals. I always appreciate that so much, that they all have a personality and they all have like their own things going on. So like when there's like a main story, you have obviously the main characters and they get like 99% of the attention, but sometimes it goes over to like this one dude that's in their friend group, and like maybe you get to see him, like maybe he does like ballet on like Sundays or something. Right, like some like details to just add to them is what makes them great. Right? That's what makes like a story feel whole,
by adding individuality to everything. That's what like makes it slay.
And
that is the difficult part
of adding such originality into everything. It's really difficult. Really, really difficult. It takes a long time.
But I would love to do it at some point. I don't really think that I can commit at this point, though. I think I've got so many things going on in my life that I don't think I could commit to a book. Just out of nowhere.
At some point, I might just get inspiration and just commit to it. But at this point, I'm not. I don't have that, like, commitment feeling of, like, I'm gonna write a book.
No. I'm cool with my little short stories that I have going on.
I'm fine with that. Really cool, honestly. Ugh, laggy. Jesus. Yeah.
Imagine me making a book. Oh my god. If I ever make a book, I'm never gonna let Netflix touch it. And if I do, I'm gonna create a freedom. They're not touching nothing.
Because, like, I know that I'm gonna write something that's, like, in university, right? It's very, like, Netflix coded, isn't it? And, like, it's a love story. It's, like, pretty new age with, like, a lot of, like, more diverse characters. Like, it's just... It's very Netflix coded.
And by that, I mean, like, it feels like something that Netflix would try to buy from you.
And I'm never gonna let Netflix touch it. If they do, it's gonna be very much like Heartstopper. Like, it's gonna be original to the work. You know?
Goodness, goodness, goodness.
Wait, how much space do we have in the chests? Okay. I think I want to keep it like that. Because I need a little bit of space if I ever need to, like, throw off, like, a few stones or deep slates. I need to make sure that there's, like, space for that. So, we're gonna have to leave that there. And then, like, when we remove from the chests down in the mine, we need to get them up. And we're gonna have to put them in the extra storage room. Hello? We also need to make new maps. New. No, wait. More maps. Oh, brain. Is this full? Almost. It's almost full. There you go. I think I'm gonna have to go down here and do this. This is how we're gonna fix. Oh, it's dead. I'm gonna have to fix my pickaxes.
That's the way I do it, by the way.
I get all the chickens to grow up and then I kill them. I know how. Okay, it's full everywhere. Problematic.
Is that okay?
Up we go. How do we feel? Do we want to end it earlier? Jesus, there's so many animals here. I swear to God. Look at all of that. We really need to move them. It's not been 2 hours. That's disappointing. We don't have much to do, though. We do not want to mine again. Like, I'm going to fall asleep live on stream if we continue to mine. I get tired so easily. Again, because I, like, I'm talking non-stop. But the thing is, like, we don't have much to do. Because everything else is kind of the same as mining. It's, like, the farm, and that also gets us tired. It's a very chill thing. And, like, we gotta plant Copperdale, but I can't really, like... It's not something that you just sit down and plan. It's just something that, like, you continuously think about until you figure it out. You know? I'm gonna have to look at designs. I should try after stream to try and find a design for the farm, like the animal farm. And so that we can build that and move all the animals, because that's where, like, the llamas, the horses, and all of that is gonna be. I also, we need to decide on what this is gonna be, like, this main house here. Are we gonna keep that a, like, for the horses here? Or what should we do about this? No idea. Right, the LAs. They need a home, too. And Kermit. Man, we're struggling with animals these days. We really are. I really don't want to deal with the maze. They're confusing. Why do they just know Iron Golem's here? Every time, I swear to God. Oh, Jesus. All that talking about TV series and films made me want to watch something, but I don't know what to watch. See, that's our problem. We are both struggling with this right now. I want to watch stuff too. I don't know what. I'm rewatching The Eclipse right now, and I want to finish rewatching Together, but then I don't know. I don't know.
A lot of shows that I'm waiting to watch are being worked on right now, so I'm a bit of a, like, just waiting. Like, I'm waiting for 23.5, I'm waiting for Only Friends, I'm waiting for... Well, the thing is, I don't really give a shit about Cooking Crush, but I'm so desperate for something to watch that I'm waiting for it now. It's the same thing with Last Twilight. I don't really give a shit about that either, but I'm waiting for it anyways. I don't know what to tell you. Oh, I'm waiting for Faceless Love too. Faceless Love looked really interesting. You guys should check that out. It is a love story, but whatever. It's not that bad to watch people fall in love, okay? Sue me. It's fun. People are happy.
I'm having a blast looking at people becoming happy.
Personally?
There's something, like, really sweet about it. No, I really like it.
Rom-coms is, like, superior to me.
Not to say, like, anything else is bad, but just, like, to me... I really enjoy comedy a lot, and people becoming happy. And, like, those are the two, like, the two genres that, like, is about people being happy, isn't it? Like, romance and comedy, right?
So rom-coms is, like, perfect for me. You know, perfectly made for me. Absolutely great.
Hey, I just like them being happy. I like seeing people be happy and, I don't know, enjoy life, I guess. If that makes any sense. My neighbors again yelling for no reason. I live in this, like, very, like, family neighborhood.
So, like, there's a lot of kids, like, in, like, damn near every apartment.
But because of that, they have this thing of, like, they don't go and knock.
They just yell
for each other. We did the same thing when I was a kid too, but
still. They would basically, you would yell at them. And be like, when are you coming out to play?
And I get it, but please.
Be silent, child.
Please.
I beg you.
Like, please stop. I'm not going to stop, and I'm not planning on stopping them, but still. You can ask.
Also, by the way, I do this thing, right, where, like, I'm streaming on Spotify, try to get all of the BTS members up to my, like, top 10 artists of all time. It's a blast. I'm having a really good time.
But,
bro, Jimin from BTS
skyrocketed
on my list, and I don't know what the hell happened. Like, skyrocketed through it. Like, I don't know. Like, it really didn't go that long. Like, only a few days. And suddenly he, like, managed to get to the spot where I wanted him to be. I have no idea how it went so quick. Like, usually it takes a really long time. So I have no idea how it went so quickly.
Because right now it's about been, like, the same, like, amount of days. For another
person. I'm on... Wait, who am I on now? June. I'm on June now to try and get him up where I want him to be.
And, like... Bro.
He's not nowhere near right now. Like, basically, when I was a kid,
Well, I'm still a kid, but whatever.
When I was younger,
I was a big fan of Glee.
And obviously, that means that I played a lot of Glee on Spotify.
So that's been like my second like artist since like 2016 or something. So I have had to literally block Glee to get that shit out of the way. So now I'm trying to get like the BTS members up there.
Because they're doing like solo stuff now, so
it's like easier.
Yippee! But for fuck's sake, guys.
I swear to God.
Why the hell did I play so much Glee? Because like, it's seriously the biggest challenge to try and get everybody up there.
Also, I can't even manage to get Jungkook up there because he has like two songs.
He has two songs that he's properly credited on.
I'm struggling,
but it's okay.
Also, speaking of Jungkook, you can go guys and listen to his solo. His solo song was releasing on July 14th at 1 p.m. Korean time.
Go listen to that.
I have no idea what it is about, but it's supposed to be... He says that it's a summer vibe, so whatever that means. I mean, if it's a summer vibe, then I'm probably gonna vibe with it. Summer vibe songs are great, okay? They are objectively good. We need happy vibes, so I'll take it. I really will. Just give it to me.
Okay.
What do we have to do? We really don't have anything, which is annoying. Because I want to stream longer, but... The thing is, either you guys will fall asleep or I will fall asleep. So there's really not a lot of winning going on. What the hell? The fact that this is still here. I can't remove it yet because we're not done. This is how I get an overview of everything. On the map, the trees look so much bigger. Like, this forest looks a lot bigger. But it really isn't that big. Not really.
It's not that many trees.
We're gonna remove, like, a few of these trees. And add to the harbor. But, like, most of them are gonna stay. I've already removed removed a few here. Probably gonna have to remove some more. They should be fine. I like it though. There's a lot of trees though. Like a lot. You also haven't been to the Nether in such a long time. What did we do in the Nether before? Sad noises. Why the hell is a bee here? Jesus Christ. Like, I know that we built the like Nether house, but what did we do before? Oh shit. Yeah. Saw that coming.
Ah!
Jesus Christ. I can't remember. Maybe it must have been when we collected stuff.
Maybe that's it. When we collected stuff for the Nether base. It wasn't when we were building it that I was thinking. I was thinking of when we were collecting stuff for it.
That was probably what. Because we worked on that for quite a bit. Not too long, but a good while.
I think I did a lot off stream as well, though. Maybe that's why.
Wait, what? We got 7? Okay. Slay, I guess? What did I put on my minions? not there. Huh. Where are they? Have I used all of them? But I know. Oh my god, dude, stop. You guys are so annoying. Stop. Please. Why? You know what? Fine. Come in. Why? Huh? Why? Bell, cotton. Bora. What do we name all these? You are definitely absolutely dumb. I can't believe I named it Red Eagle. That's such a lame joke.
You guys remember how I said, like, I'm watching the eclipse, right?
Yeah, that yolk is from there.
And the eclipse have two special episodes.
And in episode one, they do this, like, whole just...
It's just a big joke.
But basically, like, the actors, like, has... Basically, the characters go to this, like, cinema thing where they, like, imagine themselves as some characters.
So they dress up, right?
The actors dress up as these characters.
And they do this, like, little fun, like, very cringe, like...
You know, little scene where they, like, the characters are other
characters, I guess.
And one... The two main characters are called Ak and
Ayan.
And Ayan. Ayan's character is called a Red Eagle.
And Ak's character is called...
Is it the Golden Eagle or something? It's just so dumb. Bad joke. Bad joke.
That whole episode just gives me just half trauma. Like, it's to the point where, like, my whole body just cringes. It's supposed to be cringe. It's just for jokes.
Just for jokes.
But god, it really just gets me.
The series is called The Eclipse, and it's... I don't know, spoiled. Well, there's a romance, obviously, but it's plot, too.
You know, it's plot-heavy as well.
I really like plot-heavy stuff.
That I know. That I can tell you about stuff that I like. I like plot-heavy stuff.
This is about Ak and Ayan. Ak is like...
Do you guys know what a prefect is? I didn't know what a prefect was before, but apparently that's like a thing. It's basically like a group of people that like helps to like keep the rules in like the school, you know? They're like student police, apparently.
I didn't know that was a thing before this, but apparently it is. Didn't know that. But Ak is one of those prefects.
He's like the main prefect.
So obviously he's like, he keeps the rules in the school, right? And then this new kid, Ayan, is literally the opposite.
You know, like, just like, he's not vibing with this whole like rule shit.
And the whole idea is basically the school is like extremely strict, like to a point where like, they're not even like listening to the students and their opinions. They're just like, nah.
Nah.
Nah. And it's this whole, like, curse thing of, like, when they break the rules, like, a curse
comes and, like, punishes them, basically.
I know that there's, like, supposed to be an order to them, but I can't remember. But
whatever. Bad things happen to you if you break the rules.
And it's this whole thing of, like, obviously, Ak
is on the school's side, right, with the whole
curse thing and blah, 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 blah.
And Ayan is obviously
not on the school side.
And thinks that the school is being an idiot, which it is, by the way. Ayan is on the right side. Spoiler alert. He's on the right side.
Support him.
He really was, like, really biased there.
It's true, though.
It's true. He is the right one to support, but still.
I don't know. I just really like it. I think it's just because I like, the entire trope thing. It's pretty, like, a pretty basic
story.
It's not anything, you know. You know, it's not going to have an Oscar.
You know. It's, like, it's... I like it.
Yeah. I mentioned that before about, like, every character have, like, individuality.
And I do think that, like, the Eclipse succeeds with that really well.
It gives all of them, like, their own kind of thing. So it's not just, you know, Ak's friend.
You know, like, it's not like that.
Ak has these friends.
Yeah, that's true. But they are, like, their own people. So, like, you can think of it as, like, you know, Ak's friend.
This is Ak's friends, but also, like, this is, you know, what's
friends, Ak and
whatever else.
You know, like, you can think anyway from any perspective because they all kind of are their own people.
I like that. And like I said, I really like something that has, like, a lot of plot to it. Not just, you know, meat falling in love. Wow, Disney.
You know?
I like something that's actually a bit interesting. I think you should make up your mind on your own, but I think it's really good.
I like it.
Considering that I've been watching it for 8 times now.
I like it. You know? Surprise. But I like it.
Yeah. It's good. This is not a show that I could watch otherwise, so I'm just stuck
with that show, I guess.
Until I find something good. We're lacking a lot of good stuff these days, aren't we? We need more.
We really do.
I think it's this thing of, like, HBO has kind of given us really kind of good quality stuff, but nobody really likes HBO, you know? It's kind of like a teacher that, like, can teach out really well, but the teacher is, like, an asshole, you know?
Kind of that vibe. Nobody really likes HBO, but they like the stuff.
And they're also, like, pretty slow with, like, giving out shit. And Netflix is just a fucking mess.
Like, it's a mess. I don't know what's going on there, but it's a mess. Right?
I don't even know. So we're kind of stuck with these smaller little good shows, I guess.
But we're just gonna have to lose. I don't know what to tell you. We're not winning this battle.
Clearly not.
Got your chicken. Jesus. I'm not even hearing the music right now, but I can hear, like, in my soul. I can hear it in my soul, everybody. That scared me. I don't know how to turn it down. I don't know what to tell you.
I've been trying.
I don't know how to do it. You guys are just gonna have to get scared. I don't know what to tell you. So much louder than the stream audio. I know, right? I noticed that too. Guys, I literally scare myself. When I like look through my VODs, literally scare myself.
I get it. It's.
I share sympathy here. Okay.
I understand you.
The struggle is real. But yeah, guys, thanks so much for watching.
I guys should turn it on my headset so I can hear the music.
Oh Jesus, that's loud. Well, thank you so much for watching, everybody. I hope you guys had a great day. I'm gonna leave and I'm going to die. Metaphorically. You see the social media on the screen. If you don't, I'm gonna read it out for you and explain it to you. On Twitch, I'm Sapiba Live. I'm live every Saturday and Sunday at 2 p.m. Swedish time. If I'm late, no, I'm not. I'm not late. I'm never late. Okay? Good. On Twitter, I am Sapiba's DMs. On Instagram, I'm Sapiba _MH. And on YouTube, my main channel, it's just Sapiba. I know I haven't posted in like ages. We don't talk about that. But on my VOD channel, I post my VODs every Monday and Tuesday at 2 p.m. Swedish time, and that is just Sapiba's VODs. Nothing more problematic than that.
And, you know, follow if you want. If you look in the chat right now, there should be a link to my Discord if you want to go join that. Again, I don't really get Discord, but do whatever you want.
Get friends. I don't know what to tell you. I don't really get it. Apparently, I'm supposed to talk to you guys there. I didn't know that's what I was supposed to do. Sorry. Shit. I guess. It's fine. I'm gonna be back tomorrow. And I have no idea what we're doing. I think I'm leaning more towards Sims 4 and doing a little bit of upgrading again. Trying to fix the world. Also, I added McDonald's to Minecraft. We should do that. I added McDonald's to Sims. So maybe we could go eat McDonald's with my Sims tomorrow. Maybe we should do that. It didn't work last time I did it, but that was also probably because I brought like 8 people. So, you know? Maybe do a movie night? Oh, that would be cool. Good idea. I'll write that down. I hope you guys have a great day. I'm gonna go now. Eat, sleep, and drink. Take care of yourselves. I hope you guys have a great day. Compliment someone's hair today. That should be today's thing. Compliment someone's hair. Okay? I'll see you guys tomorrow. Okay? Bye, everybody. Bye.